So how do you practice trading risk-free? In this video, I'm going to go over some of the pros and cons of paper trading and how to use the Thinkorswim platform to paper trade. Hey, how's it going? On this channel, you will learn the steps I took to go from trading with a full-time job to trading as a full-time job. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And today we're looking at paper trading in the Thinkorswim platform. The best part about paper trading or trading with fake simulated money is that it's risk-free. You don't have to put any of your money on the line to test out or learn how to trade in the stock market, because that's a big fear or maybe setback for a lot of people is that, oh, to start trading or to learn, I have to put my money on the line, but that's actually not true. You can use paper trading to get that stress and risk out of there. Because you don't have to put your money on the line, that creates a less or stress-free environment, so you can really just dive into learning how to trade instead of having to deal with all the emotional swings of either making or losing money that comes with trading. Another awesome thing about being able to paper trade is that it allows you to learn the platform. You don't want to accidentally have money on the line in a trade and accidentally hit the wrong button that could lose you potentially thousands of dollars. Being able to practice everything in a stress-free and risk-free environment while you're just learning the platform is really important. While you're learning the platform, this also allows you to practice a trading strategy and hone in your trading strategy. A big important thing about trading in the stock market is creating a strategy and then seeing where that strategy works and doesn't work. One of the best ways to do that without having to risk your money is doing that paper trading. And doing that paper trading also builds your confidence in the trading strategy, because you are able to see that you are able to be profitable with that trading strategy while trading it in almost real-time conditions. Working out a strategy based on just past performance doesn't really work. The only way to really test a strategy is to test it forwards and test it either in real time with a paper trading account or putting your money on the line with a real account. The smartest way to do that is using a paper trading account, so you don't have to risk your money on maybe a strategy that isn't going to be profitable. A big thing to keep in mind though is that paper trading definitely does not equal real money trading. Because you don't have all the stress of risk and your own money on the line, it will not simulate exactly what it will be like. It's a lot easier to follow your trading strategy in a simulation because you don't have that money to affect you emotionally. It's easy to say that, oh, it won't affect me, but emotions in the stock market play a huge role, and never downplay the fact that emotion is going to affect you, because the swings of our own money affect our emotions greatly, and that will cause us to maybe sway from our trading plan and affect our returns in the end, which maybe the paper trading wouldn't have had happen. With the fact that it is paper trading, it can be easiest to not take it serious because it is just play money, and you can really mess around playing with a huge sum of money that they usually give you, but you need to take it seriously because you are going to be using this potential strategy that you're testing with your own money in the end, and you're not going to be wanting to mess around then. Knowing that your strategy is profitable based on you being as serious as you can and trying to make the simulation as real as possible to develop real results and a real strategy. So when you switch from paper trading to real money, it's not a huge difference in how you're trading. It's just the fact that you're actually using real money. If you traded way differently than you're going to trade when trading your real money, you're going to have much different results, and most likely there will be results that you're not going to want. So first off, how to get into Thinkorswim to paper trade, you need to first sign up for Thinkorswim. And once you have an account with them, when you are logging in, you need to make sure to change this live trading into paper trading. And then that will log you into the simulation instead of the main platform when you log in. Now that we're in the actual account, the first thing you'll notice at the top left is you actually have money. And generally you will start with 100,000, and it'll show that you have 200,000 in buying power because you have a margin account. Another important thing is up at the left, you will see that you have delayed data. And right now for me, it says I have 20 minutes of delayed data, but you should be able to call their client services and ask them to make your data not delayed so you can trade with the real time of the stock market to try and make it as close to a real simulation as possible. Now to actually trade, there are many ways to open just a buy share order on this platform, but an easy way I like to do is just go to charts. And then if I have this chart open of Apple and I wanted to buy 100 shares of Apple at the price 215, I can just right click and click buy. And that will open up this order down here of defaulted to 100 shares of Apple at the limit price of 215, because that's what I had clicked up here. And then to make that, all I have to do is send, and that'll create that order. And as you can see, because the price of Apple is above 215, it's at right now it's at 215 and a half about, I won't get filled on that because this is a limit order to get filled at when the price is exactly 215. So the price of Apple has to come down to 215 for me to get filled on those shares. If I wanted to adjust this order quickly to maybe get filled right now at Apple, all I have to do is click and drag this limit 100 that came up and get it to about the exact price that Apple is trading at. And then if I click that, it'll create this new buy order at that new price, and I can click send, and that will delete the old one and create a new one. As you can see, I got filled up here. It says I canceled and then got filled on my new order of 100 shares of Apple. And to look at that order now, I just have to go to the monitor tab, and I have these other random positions that I was messing around with earlier, but you can see right here, I have a quality of 100 shares of Apple. It says what price I got in at, and then it says how much I am up. So I'm up already a quarter of a percent on that, which is $26. You'll be able to monitor this and see as the price goes up and down. If I wanted to close this position, I can just right click and create sell order, and that'll bring up the trade tab. And down here, it'll say that I'm selling 100 shares of Apple, and then I can click confirm and send, and that will send in that sell order. Now I can go back here and I can see that that order is working to sell 100 shares of Apple. It might not get filled right away just based on the market conditions, and maybe the price moved away from the sell price that I want. So maybe I want to sell at 215 and a half, but now the price has moved down to 215. I won't be able to sell at 215 and a half because that's 50 cents above the market. And no one's going to want to buy above the current market value of that stock. Now, if you're wanting to trade options, you can go into the trade tab and it'll have the options grid. Now, to just buy a basic call option, you will have the calls on the left side here. And you can see that here, down here in the darker background and the black background, is the out of the money options. And then right here, you will have at the money options, because the price over here is about 215 and the current price of Apple is 215. And then beyond that, you will have in the money options that are more in the 200 price range and below the actual price of the current value. So just to buy a basic at the money option, I can just right click here and click buy single, and that will come up with a buy order here to default at buying 10 call options. And I can see that down here, the current price is at 155. It just moved up a cent. And I can click confirm and send, and then I'll bring up another tab and it'll show you how much that is currently charging me. Because I'm buying 10 of these and it's times 100 of that current price there. So it's $150 per each call option. And then times 10, because I'm buying 10 of them, it's gonna cost me $1,500 to buy 10 of these. It'll give me control over 1,000 shares of Apple for just $1,500 instead of having to pay $200,000. So I can just click confirm and send for that. And you can see up here, it makes that little ding. And then I got filled on 10 call options of Apple. You can see down here, because I'm looking at Apple, it'll have my positions on Apple. So you can see that I have 100 shares of Apple down here and then 10 call options of Apple as well. And it will have all the Greeks of those options, and it will also tell you how much money you're up and down for those positions you have. If I want to just sell this, I can just right click and create closing order to do that. And to make more complicated strategies, I can right click on here and click buy or sell, and you can see that it comes up with a ton of different strategies to use for options. Even though it is fun to trade with a huge size because you're given this huge account, I would suggest that you trade using the size of account you're going to use. So if you're going to just start out with a few thousand dollars, try and trade around those parameters, because it'll make it as fluid transition when you go from paper trading to real money trading. Hey, thanks for checking out this video. If you want to learn more about trading in the stock market or the Thinkorswim platform, make sure to subscribe to the channel. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And as always, if you have any comments or questions, ask them in the comments below.